Hello students, welcome to Machine Design 1. We are solving problems from gear and gear train. In the previous class, I have solved a problem from epicyclic gear train. Today also, we are going to solve one more problem from epicyclic gear train. Let us read the question. Listen to the question very carefully because very important question. In an epicyclic gear train, the internal wheels A and B and compound wheels C and D rotate independently about axis O. The wheels E and F rotate on pins fixed to the arm G. E gears with A and C, F gears with B and D. All the wheels have the same model and the number of teeth are TC28, TD26, TETF18. Sketch the arrangement. So in the question, they didn't give this diagram. Okay, they didn't give this diagram. This diagram we have to draw. So for drawing this diagram, they will give mark. How we are going to draw this diagram? For that, we have to read the question again and again very carefully. So first thing is the internal wheels A and B and compound wheels C and D rotate independently about axis O. So there is a point O. There is a point O. About this point, compound gear CD rotates. So about this point, compound gear C and D. I don't know which one is C and which one is D. That I don't know. But in the question, they told that TC is 28 and TD is 26. So smaller one is 26, bigger one is 28. So smaller one is D, bigger one is C. Okay, then they told that it is having two wheels, two internal wheels, they are rotating about the center O. See, you have to draw with the compass. Okay, you have to draw with compass. Since I don't have that provision in this software, I couldn't use the compass. Otherwise, I would have drawn neat circle. Okay, using compass, you have to draw neat circle. Okay. Here also, I don't know which one is A and which one is B. Okay, but one of this is A and one of this is B. That I have to find out. So let me find out that also. How I am going to find out? For that, we will read the question again. In this question, they told that E and F rotates on pins fixed arm G. Okay, so two gears are there. They are on the arm. Okay, among that, one gear E. Gear E is gear with A and C. So, one gear is connecting A and C. And another gear is connecting B and D. Okay, so how I am going to find A and B? So they told that both E and F are having same number of teeth. So the one which is connected with the C will connect the outermost gear, and one which is connected with the D will connect the innermost gear. Since they are having same teeth, this is the only possible option. So what is connecting C? So this is A and this is B, because C E A is one pair. Okay, then D F B is another one pair. Okay, see this diagram carefully. I'll give you some time.
காலையில அழைச்சு சொல்லுங்க, காலையில வந்து என்ன இப்ப போயிட்டு வண்டி கொடுத்தாதான் வண்டியை கொடுத்து
நான் எப்படி அம்மா கையில கையில ஏமாந்து வீட்டு சரி உங்க அண்ணி வண்டி இங்க இருந்தது வண்டி மட்டும் ஒரு 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 பத்து நிமிஷம் நான் வர்றேன் டே வர்றேன் ஒரு பத்து நிமிஷம் போது சாவி சரி ஒரு பத்து நிமிஷம் நான் வர்றேன் ஓகே I hope you have seen the diagram carefully. Okay, now we will proceed further. Now we will proceed further. Now we will proceed further. Let me erase it. That's what they have drawn there. Okay, you have to draw neatly. You have to draw the diagram neatly like this. Okay, you have to draw like this. Next, we have to find number of teeth. Because they didn't give the number of teeth in A and B. So how I am going to find out number of teeth in A and B? Very simple. D A. What is the diameter of A and what is the diameter of B? If we know this, means we can find the number of teeth. So first let us find the number of diameter. Okay, so see what is this is A, no? So this circle is touching A. What is this circle? This is E. It also touches C. This will also touch here. The same circle, if you draw here, means here also it will touch. So just to see the red one, just to see the red one, okay. So this is E, and this is C. This is also E. So two times E, one times C. What is the number of teeth in E? 18. Two times 18, the answer will be 36. TC, what is the answer for TC? 28. Add, you will get, I think 64. Okay. Next. Which circle touch gear B? F. Another side of F is touching gear D. So one more time, if you draw gear F, means two times F and one time D. Now add together. Two times 18 means 36. Plus D is 26. Answer 62. So we got number of teeth. Okay, we got number of teeth. This is how we have to find out the number of teeth. So let me erase it so that I can move to next step. Next step, let me use the question again. Here they are given two cases. Okay, in the first case, arm is making 100 rpm. Okay, and A is fixed. in the first case A is fixed. In the second case also arm is making 100 rpm, but A makes 10 rpm in counterclockwise direction. So remember this. So we are having two case. So first of all we have to draw the tabulation. So we got the answer. Okay, first we have to draw the tabulation. Let me go to tabulation part. In tabulation, three columns will be there: step number, condition of motion, and revolution of elements. So three columns will be there. Under revolution of elements, first write, always you have to write arm. Okay, always you have to write arm. Then what we have to write? Let us go back to diagram and see that. So in the question, any input data is given? Yes, one input data is given. That input is gear A speed. They also given the input for arm speed also they given, but we don't want to take that one. Any speed of gear is given? Yes, one speed of gear is given, that is speed of gear A. So we have to start from A. First write A. In the tabulation, first arm we have to write, then A, wheel A. Wheel A is connected with gear E. So next one is E. Gear E is connected with gear C. But gear C and D are compound gears. Compound gears means the speed of C will be equal to speed of D. So we have to put together in one column. First of all, arm. Second, they have given only one speed value, that is A, gear A speed value. So take A first, write A first. Then A is connected with E. A is connected with E, so write E. Then E is connected with C, write C. But C and D are compound gears, so write together C, D. Now D is connected with F. F is connected with B. This is how you have to write in the column. Okay, this is how you have to write. So they have written the same thing here also. Right. What is the first condition? First condition is arm is fixed. That is the first condition. Arm is fixed. So zero. Next is always first gear will rotate at the speed of 1. Condition is. So write 1. Now I have to find the speed of E. How I can find the speed of E? So that let me write it here and I will show you here. So NE by NA equal to TA by TE. Now NA will go this side. What is the NA value? NA value is 1. That's what they have written here. Okay. Now this is a inner wheel. This is inner gear. This is inner gear. When inner gear and outer gear mess with each other, they both rotate in same direction. So here also plus, here also plus. Okay. This is into. Next. Gear E is messing with the gear C. Gear E is messing with the gear C. So NC, I need the speed of NC. So NC equal to TE by TC into NE, but what is the NE value? NE value is TA by TE into 1. What are the common terms? Cancel common terms. Now what you have? TA by TC. But this is also external gear, this is also external gear. If it is rotating in counterclockwise means it will rotate in clockwise. So if here plus means here minus. Okay. So TA by TC into 1, but minus. Next one is wheel F, that is gear F. So gear D, this gear D is messing with the gear F. So NF by ND. See, gear C speed and gear D C speed is same. So we have to write TA by TC into 1 instead of ND. We don't want to cancel anything, just write as it is. See, we know that gear C and D are rotating clockwise. If it is rotating clockwise, means gear F will rotate in anti-clockwise. So put plus in front. Next one, wheel F is messing with the wheel B. See, this is external gear and this is internal gear. So external gear and the internal gear mess with each other, means they will rotate in same direction. If it is plus, means here also plus. So NB by NF. TF by TB, instead of NF, write this value, write this value. So TF, TF cancel, write the remaining things. TA by TC into TD by TB, they are written here, okay. That's all. If the first step is correct, then the entire problem is correct. If the first step in this tabulation is wrong, then entire problem is wrong. So you have to be very careful while writing this first step in the tabular column. Let me erase it till that you see the values in the tabulation. In the next step, what you have to put? In the next step, wheel A is rotating at the speed of X. Okay, so in all the columns, instead of 1, we have to write X. In all the column, instead of 1, we have to write X, because wheel A is rotating at the speed of X. Okay, this is what they have done here. Same values will repeat, but instead of 1, you have to put X. In all the places, instead of 1, you have to put X. Next step, we are going to add Y in all the columns. Add Y. Next step, step 2 and 3. Step 2 plus step 3. 0 plus Y, Y. X plus Y, X plus Y. Here Y plus X into TA by TE. Here Y minus X into TA minus TC. Here Y plus X into TA by TC into TD by TF. Here Y plus X into TA by TC into TD by TB. Okay. Otherwise, you can put set bracket like this. Otherwise, you'll get confused. Put the set bracket like this. You have to put X inside the set bracket, okay? Otherwise, you might do wrong calculations. What is the next step? In the next step, substitute the values. We know that this is case 1. This is case 1, okay? This is case 1. In case 1, G makes 100 RPM. That is, Y is 100. 100 in clockwise. So, Y equal to minus 100. 100 in clockwise means Y equal to minus 100. Okay, wa? Then, wheel A, this is making 0 revolution. So X plus Y equal to 0. So X equal to minus Y. So X equal to 100. Put these values. So Y equal to minus 100 and X equal to 100. Put these value in this place. And substitute TA, TC, TD, TB value. You will get 4.2 RPM. Then case 2. In case 2, G is 100 RPM clockwise, Y is minus 100, but A is making 10 RPM in counterclockwise. X plus Y equal to 10. Okay, put remaining values. You will get X as 110. So here you have to put Y as minus 100. Here X is 110. Then TA, TC, TD, TB value. If you put means, you will get 5.4 RPM as answer. That's all. Okay. So more example problems are there in the RS Kurmi book, in your book. Solve those problems. You will get more ideas. So if you practice more problems, you can solve the problem quickly and correctly. So solve more problems. At least solve example problems.